Well, joining us now, Prasanna Hegodu, the theatre director and founder of Charaka. Thank you very much for joining in today. Now, you've had to deal firsthand with the fallout of the pandemic and the lockdown. Your organisation, Charaka, which supports hundreds of handloom weavers, had to stop operations because of COVID. Now, if this happens to a successful, profitable venture like yours, then this is perhaps a reflection on the true state of the industry. Would you agree?
Yes, we went through hell. 6 months there was no sale, and we could not stop giving yarn to the weavers. So we kept on giving yarn to the weavers. We are a profitable society. We produce a premium product. We produce 30,000 meters of naturally dyed handloom fabric every month. We are the biggest in India. But even then, you know, the cash dried up. So we went through a crisis, but then we have bounced back because of help from the customers, the consumer. We told the consumer that, look, you can save the handmade. And that's what helped us. And as far as the society is concerned, the people, the weavers and the women, mostly we are a women's cooperative society, they actually could not weave, could not dye, could not print. So what they did was, for about 2 months, they did mud work. The entire charka was redone with mud plastering, mud flooring. It was an amazing, and then there is a lake next to charka. This was desilted, and that's how they held on to the cooperative. And now we have bounced back. And after bounce back, I really feel that COVID is actually come at the right time, in the sense that, you know, today I can say that handloom is the fabric of the future. If you want to have a good future for the country, for the economy, for the society, there's no way but to treat this not as a dole-giving sector, but as a sector which has to be taken seriously, a sector which has to be invested in, as Lailaji was trying to say. Thank you.
It's really important, Prasanna. Thanks very much for pointing that out. You know, there's this urgent need just to pay attention to handloom and to do that quickly. You know, we've given so much help to the software sector for exports, and we really have helped them, and they've done very well. And they're huge exports, and we are proud of it. But let me tell you, our handloom could be as big if we treated it in the same way and gave incentives and help and focused on it. I think that's the point you're making. You know, there's a revival happening in the economy, and we can't ignore the handloom sector for much longer. Would you agree with that?
Yes. You know, most people don't know, most bureaucrats don't know, most politicians don't know that the active looms in India, even now, in spite of all the horrors that we have done to the sector, is bigger than the rest of the world put together. We have more active looms than China can ever imagine, or Vietnam can ever imagine, Korea can ever imagine. So if you really want to beat them, you can only beat them with the hand loom, with the cotton. You see, we are cotton people. China is silk people. We've always been cotton people. We've always been indigo people. And nobody else has this. You know, this is premier product, you know. So we need to understand this, invest in it. Yeah.
Right. Prasanna ji, thank you so much for sharing with us what you've gone through and what the area has gone through. Thank you so much indeed.